Good afternoon, dear students. Today we are going to discuss soy sauce production. Okay, so here we are going to study the production of three different types of oriental fermented food. This is one of the oriental fermented food. We are going to study soy sauce production, then miso production and sufu production. So let us begin now here with the first oriental food preparation, that is soy sauce. Okay. Now, soy sauce is a dark brown liquid having a salty taste and a pleasant aroma suggestive of a bit of meat extract. It is used as a seasoning agent and as a substitute of salt in food preparation as well as a table condiment because it contains almost 18% of salt. So, it's a seasoning agent being used as a substitute for salt in food preparation as well as a table condiment. Soy sauce enhances the flavor of the food. It adds to the color of the meat, seafood, and other vegetables, right? So let us study how it is produced. So the soy sauce is produced by fermentation of a combination of soya beans, cereal, that is wheat, and salt. Okay. So here we have studied the production of soy sauce using soybean, wheat, and salt. Okay. The fermentation process for soybean production involves, for soy sauce production involves following steps. Step one is soaking and cooking of soybeans, then mixing with roasted wheat, and number two, koji preparation, number three, brine fermentation, and number four, pasteurization and bottling of soy sauce. So let us study the first step, that is soaking and cooking. Now soybeans are usually soaked overnight in water. Okay, the first step is soaking of soybeans. So soybeans are usually soaked overnight, say 10 to 12 hours in water, drained, and then they are steamed for several hours, steaming to cook them for several hours. Now cooking is generally done by autoclaving at 10 to 13 pounds per square inch pressure for a period of about 1 hour, but cooking at high temperature for shorter time is a current trend. Right. So a batch type cookers are used to cook soybeans at 120 degrees Celsius and the temperature is quickly lowered. Okay. So generally we can go for autoclaving for cooking the soybeans. So soybeans have to be soaked in water overnight, drain the water and cook them by steaming. The cooked soybeans are now mixed with roasted and cracked wheat. So on the other hand, we have roasted and cracked. Wheat are not, you can say, cooked. They are roasted and they are cracked. Okay. Crushed, rather. Coarsely ground. Okay. The cracked wheat and soybeans, cooked soybeans, are mixed. In the ratio of soybean to roasted and cracked wheat, ratio is 50 is to 50 by weight or 52 is to 48 by volume. Now, wheat, when added to the soybeans, decreases the nitrogen content, total nitrogen content of soy sauce, but it contributes to aroma and flavor. So, it has to be mixed. Right. Now, the second step is koji preparation. So, in step one, we soak the soybean, we cook them. On other hand, we roast the wheat, we crush them, mix the soybean and wheat in a mixture, in a concentration of 50 is to 50 by weight or 52 is to 48 by volume. Now, you have a mixture containing soybean and wheat. Now, the next step is koji preparation. The soybean-wheat mixture is inoculated with a starter culture, which is known as ten koji at the rate of 0.1 to 0.2%. Meaning what? You have to add 0.1 or 0.2% of starter culture or ten koji into the soybean-wheat mixture. So, the soybean wheat mixture is to be inoculated with the starter culture. A good starter culture must give characteristic aroma and flavor to soy sauce. Okay. Having high proteolytic and amylolytic activities and must be easy to culture. The starter ten koji is made by using the strains of Aspergillus oryzae or Aspergillus soy or the mixture. So, the starter ten koji is made by using strains of the mold Aspergillus oryzae and or Aspergillus soy. The pure cultures are grown These organisms are grown separately on cooked rice for a period of 3 to 5 days at 30 degrees Celsius until the rice is covered with spores. It should be spores, okay? Which are then harvested. Okay, so the starter culture which you require is of Aspergillus oryzae or Aspergillus soyae. This organism is first cultivated or cultured on cooked rice for 3 to 5 days for at 30 degree. Okay, when the rice becomes covered with the spores of Aspergillus, we harvest the spores of Aspergillus oryzae or soyae. Okay, and these spores are used to inoculate the soybean wheat mixture. Ten koji is usually a mixture of pure spores consisting of several strains in appropriate proportion. Okay, so purely spores of various strains of Aspergillus in a mixture can be used. Okay, so what is ten koji? Is a mixture of pure spores consisting of several strains in appropriate proportion. Now, the inoculated mixture means what? The wheat, soybean inoculated with ten koji. So the inoculated mixture is distributed in shallow pans, okay, or shallow trays or shallow wooden boxes to about 5 centimeters in depth, and they are then incubated at 30 degrees Celsius. Okay, so this wheat plus soybean mixture inoculated with 10 koji is now distributed in shallow trays or in wooden boxes up to a depth of about 5 centimeters and then incubated at 30 degrees Celsius. After 24 hours, the mixture is covered with a thin white growth of mold. Okay, within 24 hours, a thin white mycelial mass develops. Now you allow the mold growth to continue. As the mold growth continues, the temperature of the mixture could rise above room temperature to 40 degrees Celsius or higher. Therefore, the mixture has to be stirred or turned periodically to maintain uniform temperature and moisture and aeration. Okay, so as it continues, the temperature may increase. So you have to stir it, turn the mixture so as to maintain proper moisture throughout temperature and aeration. As the incubation time increases, the mold continues to grow, and their growth first turns yellow and then dark green. The moisture then gradually decreases. After about 72 hours of incubation, the molded mixture called shoyu koji is ready for brine fermentation. Okay, so what is the incubation period? Say about 72 hours. So you incubate the wheat soybean mixture with 10 koji for 72 hours. In between, you stir it or turn it, and then the moisture will also gradually decrease, and the molded mixture which now is formed is called as shoyu koji, is ready for brine fermentation, that means for addition of pulp. Shoyu koji superior quality has dark green color because of the mold, pleasant aroma, sweet but bitter taste, and high activities of proteases and amylase enzyme. Now we go for third step, that is brine fermentation. The shoyu koji is transferred into a deep vessel in which equal volume of salt solution is added to make it or convert it into mash or moromi. Okay, so the shoyu koji developed in the second stage is transferred to a deep vessel where we add equal volume of salt solution. What is the concentration of salt? 17% to 19%. It is added so that the mixture that is formed is called as mash or moromi. Recently, the volume of salt solution has been increased to 1.1 to 1.2 times that of koji. Not equal, we'll say. As I said here, that equal volume was added, but nowadays the volume of salt has been increased from 1.1 times or 1.2 times that of koji. Okay. Now the salt concentration less than 16% will cause putrefaction. So it has to be more than 16%. Okay. Now pure culture of yeast and bacteria are now added to the mash to accelerate the fermentation and to improve the flavor of the final product. So now you add pure cultures of yeast and bacteria so as to carry out yeast fermentation and lactic acid fermentation to improve the flavor of the final product. So what organisms are used here? Strains of Saccharomyces rauxii, Turriolepsis yeast, and Pediococcus soyae impart flavor to the product. So they are important flavor producers which are now added. Okay, now to the mash or moromi, we add aspergillus, the yeast and lactic acid bacteria also. So we can add Saccharomyces rauxi, Turrilopsis or Pediococcus. Now, the initial pH of the mash is 6.5 to 7, which gradually decreases because of lactic acid fermentation. Okay, it gradually decreases because of lactic acid fermentation. So as lactic acid fermentation advances, the initial pH of 6.5 to 7 decreases to around 5.5. As the pH reaches 5.5, yeast fermentation will start. Okay, yeast fermentation takes place. The mash of moromi is stirred occasionally during the early stage to provide enough aeration for good growth of yeast and to prevent the growth of undesirable anaerobic microorganisms, to maintain uniform temperature and to facilitate removal of CO2. Okay, so the mash of moromi is initially occasionally stirred after adding the yeast or lactic acid bacteria. We occasionally stir it. Why? For good aeration, to remove CO2, to maintain uniform temperature, to prevent the growth of undesirable anaerobic microorganism. But too much of stirring should be avoided because too much of stirring hinders fermentation. Now, good quality shoyu, that is soy sauce, can be obtained in 6 months fermentation. That means the aging period may be as long as 6 months, because good quality of soy sauce is obtained after 6 months fermentation, when the temperature of the moromi is controlled as follows. You have to control the temperature in the following manner. In the beginning, it should be 15 degrees for a month, then 28 degrees for 4 months for yeast, and then again 15 degrees for 1 month during finishing. So this is the temperature that has to be maintained for 6 months during the period of aging, and we get good quality soy sauce then. Okay, so after aging is over, we go for pasteurization of the product and bottling of the product. The matured mash is finally pressed. We have to press the mash so that the liquid is removed, and the liquid is pasteurized to 70 to 80 degrees Celsius to stop microbial growth and enzymatic reactions. Okay, so the matured mash or moromi is pressed so that the liquid and the press cake are removed. The press cake can be used for animal feed. The liquid is subjected to pasteurization at a temperature of 70 or 80 degrees Celsius so that the microbial activities as well as enzymatic reaction stop. The liquid is then filtered to remove all the precipitates, and the filtered liquid is bottled for market as soy sauce. In Japan, either benzoic acid or butyl parahydroxybenzoate is added as preservative. Okay. And a good soy sauce has a salt concentration of about 18% and a pH of about 4.6 to 4.8. So that is all about production of soy sauce. Let us discuss in brief with this flow sheet. The wheat are roasted and crushed. Soybeans are soaked and cooked. Then the crushed wheat and cooked soybeans are mixed together in say 50-50 proportion, and then you have to inoculate it with the starter culture. So the starter culture of mixed strains of Aspergillus like Aspergillus oryzae, Aspergillus soy are mixed, and then the mixture is incubated in the incubation room by transferring it into shallow boxes. Incubation may proceed up to 72 hours. Okay, after 72 hours, koji is ready. Okay, the shoyu koji or the mold, the wheat and soybean mixture with mold, that is called as koji, is ready for brine fermentation. At that stage, you have to add salt solution. Okay, what is the concentration of salt? 17 to 19%. Okay, in what volume? Equal volume or more than more than equal? That's 1.1 or 1.2 times of shoyu. 1.2 times of koji we have to add. Okay, when you add brine solution, what you get is mash or moromi. It is subjected to lactic acid fermentation and yeast fermentation. Okay, with the help of Pediococcus soy or Saccharomyces rauxi or Turrilla, and then it is aged for a period of 6 months. During aging, we have to control the temperature, and after aging is over, it is pressed to remove the liquid. The press cakes can be used for animal feed. The liquid is subjected to pasteurization, and then the pasteurized product is bottled so that you get final product, that is soy sauce. Okay, so that is all about soy sauce production.